Your mission remains, but a malicious tinge creeps these halls.
A tinge? And the amplifiers are down, so failing my severance, I made things worse.
Are you surprised?
The ship was changing before we arrived, Crow.
After which, things did not improve.
The amplifiers appear to be fighting an unknown interference, but they are working.
These vines wriggle into everything, changing it. Reminds me of adventuring in the Black Garden. Our turning points always seem to come by force.
Guardian
Maybe
down.
Yours.
Yes. You've had an overabundance of choice in your life. Certainly not a lost child ricocheting between authority figures. How's your stewardship of him been, Guardian?
This is between you and me.
Steady.
Listen to your handler. Wouldn't want to jeopardize the mission.
Thank you.
went smoother this time.
He's picking up on some of my old tricks. Starting to aim like me.
Using your tricks against you sounds good to me.
A lot of attitude for somebody who broke down crying last time we were here. Will your aim stay steady when the Scorn call you father?
If they attack me, if I have to.
If?
And that's the door. Keep up, Aldrin.
The Vanguard. You were supposed to be heir of the Reef. Talk about a step down. Mara must be furious.
The Queen is content that Krogh has found his own path. Amplifier established. Krogh will reach his second beacon shortly. The interference appears to be echoed by the phantoms that haunt the Leviathan's halls. It is spreading.
Lockdown is again lifted and power rerouted. Proceed.
can't imagine seeing a stranger with my sibling's face, but finding out that someone isn't who you thought they were? I understand that.
Obviously. It's your entire life.
I'm a guardian of the city. I'm sure Mara and I will work together at some point. We'll just need some realignment.
You hearing this, Guardian? 1 foot back in the reef. Prince Crow doesn't quite have the same ring to it, but we'll get by.
Funny. That's the last one. I'm ready when you are, Guardian.
Crow, you can do this. You are strong enough.
When we first touched down, I wasn't sure. But I trust you. Both of you.
I'm ready to finish this.
I empathize with your devotion to a cause, but aren't you tired of this little dance?
I hadn't found my footing before. This time, I'm ready for you.
Blade manifests from the harvester.
I told myself a story about who you were. A villain strung together from whispers of the things you'd done. But you're right. I'm scared. I'm scared that our nature might make my friends dangerous to me, or me to them. We all have parts we wish weren't there, but acknowledging them can make us stronger. I'll always be balancing on the edge of something terrible. But now I have someone to pull me back.
Who?
You. I can learn from your mistakes.
My triumphs, too.
Yeah. You point out the pitfalls, I'll fill them in. We'll right your wrongs together. See you around. Guardian. Eris. I did it.
See, you are stronger than your doubts presumed. The Leviathan's connection to the pyramid frays. Our gamble is working, Guardians.
I am delivering a status report on the Imperial Survey of the Leviathan. Our scouts confirm your reports of psychic anomalies emanating from the Red Phantoms seen throughout the ship. Scion Opti theorized that these phantoms are manifestations forged from a psychic background radiation permeating the Leviathan. Darkness. Navigational equipment shows that the Leviathan entered a gravitational anomaly and it was at once within and outside of the known universe for an indeterminate period of time. When it emerged from this state, most of its crew were missing, and an infestation of unknown fungal matter had infiltrated all decks of the ship. Command structure appears to have broken down. Loyalists who emerged from the anomaly disembarked from the Leviathan. We are attempting to determine their location. Those currently aboard are newly grown, combat-ready clones that have no higher brain function. They operate as an extension of my father's will. At Valis Forge's suggestion, I have submitted a recommendation for Crow to participate in a joint investigation to supplement our own. It is my hope that together, we can tear into the beating heart of the Leviathan and drag my father screaming to the light of your sun. Until such a time, we are Cabal, we eat the mountains, we drink the seas.
Second chances. Huh. Turns out I've been using mine wrong. I thought being a guardian was my destiny. That wielding the light for good was the most I had to offer. But it's clear now. This is what the Traveler chose me for. I was reforged in the light for a purpose. To remake something dead and gone into something beautiful. To learn how to forge something new from what we were. Everything Uldren did to the Reef, the Scorn, Fickrel. I have a responsibility. No. A calling to make them whole. And I can't replace Cade. But I can cover his old patrols. Maybe organize the hunters a bit, if they'll let me. Clean up some of my mess. I don't know if I can fix everything Uldren left broken. But I can try.
I have long said that the darkness can be used as a power for good, even when others doubted. By helping Crow to accept his past as Uldren Sov, we have changed the inherent nature of a nightmare into something new. A manifestation of healed trauma, a memory of the man Crow once was. The best of him. Uldren is as much a part of Crow as the darkness is a part of you or me. And there is more to it than pain. In this success, we have discovered the key to our victory. Through our bond, the Crown of Sorrow, we could convert the nightmares into a force against Kallus. But the process to convert these psychic constructs will not be an easy one. It is a battle.